Can you please first tell who you are and with which film you are here at the festival?
My name is Anna Odell, and I have made a film that called X and Y. And I'm the director and also the main character together with Mikael Persbrandt.
The lead actors in the film. So that's interesting about this film, that you are the actor and the director of a film in which you are playing the actor and director in a project about life and art and life imitating art and art imitating life. Can you talk about why you chose this very specific structure of the film, how you approach this?
From the beginning, I was really interested in this kind of type of man that Mikael Persbrandt is the most perfect, example of in Sweden, because he is like you can say an alpha man,
alpha male, very male. Famous personality in Sweden.
Yeah. And he is famous to he loves women and he is really hard and lovely and dangerous at the same time, and have done so much bad stuff, but he's always welcome back. And I was really interested in how the society and how we are acting to this kind of man. And in Sweden, I'm known for being like a crazy artist.
A little bit of an enfant terrible yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I wanted to play with our roles, because many people think that we are much more crazy, and I think also I'm an artist. I'm not educated in film from the beginning, and the picture of me in Sweden is like an artist woman that you can't really know, and she's crazy, I wanted to
challenge those ideas, those roles,
and also I also wanted to investigate and find something that's real.
Yeah.
But then I wanted to play with all this, and also we came each other so near when we worked with the film. So it's also a protection that mix other people's ideas about us and the reality.
There's an extra layer on top of it.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that makes me think, because you say you're not formally trained in film, but you did, when you were studying still at art school, you made a film, Unknown Girl,
I think
it was. Unknown Woman, yeah. And that was about staging a part of your own, like about mental illness and also challenging maybe the power structures of the medical world in Sweden.
Yeah.
And then you made a film, how is it called? The Reunion.
Yeah.
And that's about you challenging maybe a part of high school past, the power structures of bullying and being bullied, and now you have the power structure of man and female actor reality. What interests you in making those challenges through cinema, challenging those power structures?
Yeah, I think, if people that haven't seen my work, they can think, oh, she's really interested in herself, but for
in
me,
her ego, but
yeah,
that's not the
ego.
Case. Yeah.
No, for me, it's really I use myself and my experience to explore something that I'm interested in.
Yeah.
And when I worked with the Reunion, my first film, I were not interested to tell about my history of being bullied, but I want to explore how other people look at it from outside, and how they, if we have gone in the same school, I wanted to hear your story about how you feel when we were in school.
To and have then, new perspectives. Yeah.
Yeah. So for me, it's a way of using myself as a way to investigate other people's, you know, and when it's so tricky, when I played mentally ill, when I talked to people and did my research before, and I said that, call, you know, almost every psychiatric hospital in Sweden and said, hi, I'm an artist and I'm going to play that I'm mentally ill, and how are you going to react when I'm coming to you? Because I think I will be coming with the police because I have been have an experience of it from the reality.
Yeah.
And they said to me, oh, you can't fool us because we have the ways to see that you are not ill. But then when I ask them, okay, but when I afterwards when I say I just have played that I'm ill, what are you going to say though? Then, then we are going to think you are ill.
Yeah.
So it's, you know, when you are using yourself in a really tricky way, you can look at something that people otherwise wouldn't, you know, talk about or let you know about.
You're talking about looking, and I think that plays a big part in this film as well, because it's a lot about surveillance and about spying into people's lives. And you have this film set in the studio where there's all these little houses and rooms, and people are able to look in an interrogation room and listen to each other. Can you talk about this whole construct where you were with these actors, how you staged, let's say, this whole experiment?
Yeah, but you know, the thing was that before I because in the film it's no script.
Yeah.
But there was a script, of course. But when I start to work with the actors, there were no scripts.
Yes.
So we have, you know, research filming before we start shooting the film.
Yeah, okay.
And then we do experiments and reactments, and I used the other actors to explore something, and the other one didn't know if what I say was the truth or what the other one said. So everyone was, you know, walking on toes.
Yeah.
Because, so it was like a real life experiment before, and you know when one of the actors when Mikael met him the first time, I had told him, can you act like Mikael? But Mikael didn't know.
Yeah.
So for Mikael it was really crazy because he met some actor that was acting like him when he is really macho.
It's confronting.
Yeah. But he didn't know.
Yeah.
So many things was, you know, like how could it be if you meet yourself, or and what happens if I ask you, what do you think is my inner fear?
Or
so both my and others' thought of who I am or who he was, or you know. So it's a really complex but really funny and strange.
It's very playful in a way,
yeah.
And that. I mean, that brings me to all the actors that you worked with. I'm just going to name some names for the audience to know. You worked in this film with Jens Albinus, with Sophie Grabol, with Vera Vitali, Mikael we already mentioned, Shanti Roni, Trine, Ture Lindhardt and Trine Dierholm. Some of the greatest actors from the Nordic region in cinema.
Yeah.
What was it like to work with all this talent? Because it's amazing to see all of them in the same film.
Yeah, you know, it was wonderful to work with them because they are so talented. But for me, it was so crazy because I'm acted with them.
Yeah.
So it was really frightening, but at the same time, really, you know, spännande, exciting.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So it was both, you know, extremely hard and extremely interesting, but and crazy, because being both director and actor is really hard, and when you're working with these stars, but they were so, you know, it was many of them was like, you know, they was just doing it.
Yeah, they seem very supportive and
yeah.
into it. It's
yeah.
very funny to see them all
yeah.
play you and Mikko yeah. in all those various constructions. I have one more question for you. It's about your film at the film festival. X and Y is playing in the big screen competition. What does it mean for you to have your film here at this film festival?
It's, you know, I'm really, really happy and that you like the film, and it, I made a film that, you know, in Sweden, it's one way to see it when you know me and Mikael.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really interesting in, to meet the public in here, because I heard it works really well even if you don't know about us, and it was what I hoped for. So and I'm really grateful to be here.
Thank you so much. We're grateful that you're here. Thank you so much.
Thank you.